got three leather stamping tools here that I've made out of nails. This is a finished nail that I hammered flat and then took a file and kind of cleaned it up and some sandpaper and polished the piece. That appears to be about 1/8 inch in width, fairly thin. It's slightly flat on the end. I've used that tool. At the end of this video, I'll show you some pieces that I've tooled and carved. Well, not carved, actually just stamped. This is a stamping tutorial. But I've got a nail here. This is the sharp point, but it had kind of like burrs on it. So I lightly filed that and then polished it with this sandpaper. Here's just a round of the end. I flattened it with a file and then polished it. So I've got flat, the round, and then the pointed. I would like to have a little bit flatter tool so I can do my flowers. So what I'm going to do is snip the end of this nail off. This is a large nail. I'm not for sure what size that is. I'm going to use these side cutters. Now I've snipped that off, and what I'm going to do is use a flat file. Get this flat file and this one. This might be a little more aggressive. Anyway. Got a ball peen hammer here, and this is 5/8 thick plate steel. It's about 6 by 10, I think. Yep, that's looking good. Now, I've got that spread out wider than this other one. That's what I needed, a little wider tool. So now I'm going to flatten this with a file and kind of polish it, make sure it's not real sharp. I'll polish it with sandpaper. All right, this is the nail the big nail that I flattened. One thing about making your own tools out of nails, they're your own unique design. It'll be your trademark. Okay, that feels about right. So I've got four nail leather stamping tools that I'm going to have a little bit of fun with here. All right, I'm ready to get started here. I've got a graphite pencil. It's an 8B. And this piece of leather has been wet. It needs wetting a little bit more, and I've got a sponge right here. And I'll wet the top side. The back side has been dampened a little bit. This is 13 to 15 ounce saddle skirting. I make a lot of saddles and have a lot of leftover pieces, so that's what I'll be using. You can also do thinner pieces. You just have to be a little careful when you're striking your tool not to go all the way through. I've got the nails that I've modified for leather stamping, and I'll be using a lightweight ball peen hammer. I put a new handle in that some time ago, and it's ready to go. What I have in mind is do a little serpentine leather stamping at the bottom here, put a banner here, and then a flower and a leaf on each side, just to kind of give you some ideas of what you can do. You can start out with a set like this. What you're going to end up with is some very unique tooling that's different, and that's okay. You can also, with this nail with the sharp point, put your maker's mark, your initials or name and date, and real tiny, as you'll see. I'm going to draw directly on to my piece here, and if you're not comfortable with that, you could cut a piece of like printer paper and draw your design on to paper, and then hold it down and lightly transfer it to the piece. But this, we're just going to go just like this. Then I'm going to scratch, use my nail, and just scratch a line right across the bottom there. And let's see. Might as well go across the top too. I'll use the smaller tool for the top. This sure enough handmade, hand laid out. So it's time to get started. I think I'll start with the banner first. It'll be fun. I've got my weights here. I'm going to put my lead weights on the corners there. That holds the piece still while I do my leather stamping. This is the first time I've used this bigger nail with the wider flat on it. Right here on the ends, I'm going to my smaller nail with the flat on it. switch back to the bigger one. Go back to the smaller flat. Let's start with my flower center here. Switch to my, this is a finished nail that I flattened on the end here. Thank you. going to put a little dot at the tip of that little mark up there with my sharp point nail. This is my finished nail with the flat on it. It's got a little burr on it. Now I'm going to stamp my name in here, my last name. Thanks for taking your time watching this tutorial, tooling this piece with hammer and nails. Kind of a fun project, and it's a great way to make your own leather stamping tools. As you can see, there's a lot of definition and depth to this, so I don't see anything wrong with it at all. Kind of fun. And wish you the best with your leather craft, leather stamping, and tooling. As I promised, I'll show you some close-ups of some practice pieces I've done with hammer and nails.